Hello and welcome back. Today, have a look at the Fine Molds F4E Early Vietnam War Phantom. So, this is a new boxing, I think, from the last year or so, 2020, 2021. And, of course, I'm going to make a RAF version of this, an Australian version of this. I've ordered the decals. I've got the paints from the SEA F111 that I'm building. Just having a look through these instructions. New set of instructions, small scale, this is a 172. Come with the colours, so that's very nice. Don't know if there's any options here. It does give you some options. But in terms of models, I think it's just the one model that we're building. And comes with just some fuel tanks, it seems. Maybe no weapons. And there's a difference in canopy. You can have the double or this single version. I'm probably going to have it closed for canopy. So I might go for that version. Now the decals here are insane. The amount of decals that they've got for such a small plane. I think it's overkill. Well, look at it all. Just crazy. No colour illustration for the camo scheme, so I'll just have to look online just to make sure that we're getting the right color in the right place. And these patterns are very fine, so I might have to use either some blue tack, I think, to blue tack away the areas, and then just be very careful with it. They've got the shark's teeth on this one. I don't think the Aussie ones had that. Looking at the plastic. Plastic looks great. Everything's individually boxed. Oh, it's not individually boxed. There's three things in there. Three things in there. It's very fine, the connections, which is nice. Plastic looks really good. Probably get in trouble for saying it's kind of like the new Airfix stuff, but more like a Tamiya. Yep, really nice. Clear parts. Ooh, we're in with everything else. Clear parts aren't that shiny, actually. A little bit dull. But otherwise, pretty good panel detail. Not that deep. Not that bad. I can't see any flash at all at the moment. So that's good. That's as you'd expect from a new tooling. Look at that, look at the intricacy of the decals. Amazing. Fine Molds, 2021 actually is the date on that one. Cool, well I look forward to putting this one together. Now the paints I think will go for a matte black. Oh, whoa, we'll go for the Primer Surfacer 1000. The F111 kit, these Meng SEA camouflage colours, so the light green, the field green, and the dark tan. I just remembered I bought this, which is a Hobbymaster stand. I think it's for diecast models, but it's for a 172 jet fighter and for an F4. So I'm hoping that we can use this for the F4 Phantom that I'm building. So it's got kind of jet things that sit inside the nozzles. So let's hope that that's strong enough to hold that model up and not break off. Might have to use some decent glue. And so we'll have the wheels up, canopy down. And I don't think there's any weapons on this one anyway. I was hoping to do some weapons on my next build, but there we go. I'll look forward to doing that. A first look at the Fine Molds tooling. Very nice detail, really nice feeling plastic. It's got a bit of substance to it, so it's not light. And the connections all look pretty good, no flash, very crisp. Nice detail, not the best detail I've seen, like when you compare to the brand new Tamiya stuff, but pretty good. Just noticed something. See these two pinholes? They're the same on this side as well. They line up with the pins that are here, which is the first time I've seen something like that on a cockpit. And so that fits clickety-click straight in there. I think fantastic. So many times you're trying to jiggle around the seats, you're not sure exactly where it's supposed to be, and sometimes if there's a problem with the fit, it won't actually go together that well. But because you've got those indents or those pinholes, I mean, that's just the best I've seen. Really good. Just thought I'd take a break. I've been at this for about 2 hours now. The build's coming together really, really well. If there's any panel gaps and stuff like that, or any kind of error, a bit like that little shadow there, that is all on me. Just being a bit too quick and not holding down the model as it's curing. Other than that, it's been an absolute dream build. It's really easy to put together, takes no time. It's actually a real joy, and yeah, just good fun. It's nice to have an easy build. I think sometimes when you've got things that always have errors in them, or you need to do a lot of sanding, a lot of cleanup, there is a challenge in that. But when it all goes together very easily, it's much more fun. Because you can see it coming together quite quickly. But yeah, each to their own. And I'm enjoying this one right now. So we've just done a bit of painting. We used this MIG light grey on the bottom of the F4. I think it's more like a white really under this light, and I think I went a bit too much on it. No thinner, just went straight from the bottle, and that was just a bit glossy. We'll see how it dries out. You'll see a couple of splotches of grey there. There's a reason for that. I used flat aluminium XF16 on these tail bits, so I masked that off with this thick masking tape, which is actually no good Kamoi tape. The Tamiya stuff's much better than this. This is kind of junky, so I wouldn't buy that again. But yep, so we just masked it off and just shot it with that XF16. Also some little pieces here that go with the nozzles, and this end piece here. Just a tip with this stuff, if you sit it around for too long, all the solids go to the bottom. So I found this online. I was watching a video, and it's basically a little, kind of like a little cocktail mixer or something, and that these are made for modelling, but just great little mixers, and just clean it off with a bit of alcohol But the best way, and you can see how nice and clear that is now, that I've used the mixer with to mix this paint and shot those few items with that. That's all I wanted to show you basically. And the splotch is when I was trying to clean this and I turned it on accidentally. There's still a bit of paint and it's splattered. So that's a lesson for me. But yeah, hopefully it'll dry better than it looks at the moment. It's looking just a bit glossy. The underside's pretty good. Now onto the canopy mask and the canopy itself. We have the Edouard F4 EJ 1:72 for fine molds kit. It's got all the instructions here. It asks for a liquid mask. Interestingly, they seem to provide something down here for the tail, which is nice, but I've already kind of used, I've already done that just with normal masking tape. Oh, it's the leading edge of it is still silver, I guess. Oh well, that's something to know for future. Got the mask itself there. We've got the, this is the Tamiya finish compound. Compound comes, polishing compound comes with fine and coarse as well, which I like, but because this canopy looks pretty good to begin with, I think we're just gonna use the finish on it. It looks pretty good. There's just a few little scuff marks on it. Don't know if you can tell that here. Just a few little scuffs, and we'll just give a final polish. And I want to polish the underside as well because I sometimes get some fogging. So this one, I think what I'm going to do is use blue tack first, paint everything, take it off, do a final polish just after all the painting, and then use the canopy, this canopy glue by Zap, Formula 560. We'll use that to fix the canopy closed in space, in place, when we're finished with it. This also comes with the wheel masking pieces, which is really good, but I'm gonna have this one as the in-flight style, so. So I've just used the canopy glue, placed some on the cardboard here, and then with just a toothpick, just around the sills. And I dry fit them before and they fit perfect. So it feels like very, very snug now. Just using a Q-tip, just cleaning off the excess on the outside and see how that goes. Really happy with that. That's such a nice fit. It's probably the best canopy fit I've seen. Just trying this time the blue tack method and some masking tape just before. So I've put down the tan color and just following this decal sheet, just following the bits where the light green will go. And we're just gonna do some painting on the light green. So just here, so the main areas here are in there, kind of joins up with this bit here and then this side. And then on the left-hand side, just along here, the bottom. So I've just masked off the white bit underneath and the black nose cone. Give us the green there, little bit of green flash over here. And that seems to be the main body. And then the rest of it is the dark green. So to the paint booth and no light green over the canopy, which is great. And then just across the rear fin, I'll bring some blue tack to do that as well. So just quickly hit it with the light green. Not so happy with the coverage of the light green. I'm hoping the dark green maybe will cover it. You can see how there's areas where more paint has hit and pulled than at others. Maybe it needs a couple of coats or something. I don't know. Anyway, let's see how this looks. I guess it's all about the contrast between the colors as well. Okay. Take the tape off. The tape's stuck. Okay. Yeah, looks all right. Transition here is not the greatest, but can live with that. And then, here. Yeah. That's okay. I think what I might do with the light green is go for a second coat later. If I need to, just around the edges maybe. So one more coat to go. I might leave it for a day just to let it cure. So the underside, okay, I'm gonna try using a little bit of thinner, or maybe just water, to take that off. Yeah, let's try that now. Let's grab a Q-tip. I've got there. Coming off? Yeah, a little bit. Oh, you know what it could be? It's just me handling it. Just a dry one. Feels like it's coming off. Definitely less noticeable than it was a few moments ago. This is a dry Q-tip I'm using over here. The other thing is I'll probably hit this with a bit of weathering anyway. Yeah, there you go. It's a little bit epoxy sticky. Try not to handle it too much before I put a clear coat on. There we go. It's time to do the dark green colour. These two main patches here, a little bit on the rear side of these elevators, I guess. I'm going to leave the front bit to later. because as you can see, there's quite a lot of work just in getting those two main pieces done, and then I'll worry about the nose, which is a little bit more intricate, and probably just want to make sure that it's done right first time. What this also allows me to do is, if I need to touch up, which I probably will, any other areas on a second coat, then I could probably do that freehand without too much fuss. So let's give it a go and see what happens. This is probably the second time I've used blue tack. So far, so good on the back end here. That's quite a nice line there. I'm just trying to make sure that I give myself enough room so that if I want to go back, I can do it with some accuracy and not do too much overspraying. I'm going to use the fine brush as well. Fine airbrush, which is giving us a better line and less overspray at the moment. So we've got the three color camo on now, using the blue tack method. I'm not so happy with the difference between the light green and the dark green. I guess it might seem okay in this lighting, but just comparing it to photos and comparing it even to the illustration that I've got here, the light green seems to be a bit too dark. Tan I'm okay with, the dark green, yeah. So there's that. Otherwise I'm quite happy with the way that the blue tack worked. I think that's quite a good method. The only issue with it is quite work intensive, because you've got to do it maybe two or three coats just if there's spaces that you've missed. If I were to do this again, I would do a lot more of the tan coat, probably just do the whole thing in tan actually to begin with, and then put the camo colours, the green over the top, just so that where they meet sometimes I would have left space for the green to go in, and because of the blue tacking technique that I've got, I went a bit too close, and then so when the new paint hits, there's a gap that's formed in the middle, and you can see some of that here. I've tried to cover it up, but there is a bit of under painting, if you like. So I'm going to put these silver parts on. I think I've hopefully left enough clear plastic. I might go and scrape a bit of that area away, and similarly scrape a little bit of the underside away here to fit that. And then these will go on to that silver piece there as well. And then we're pretty much ready to clear coat. So you can see here where you've got a bit of, or I've got a bit of white still showing some of the underside there. The other bit here is just behind this black area here. I might just go over it either with a paintbrush, or I might mask away again and then hit it with some of the white. So go and do that now. Thank you. so careful when you do that. I'll show you one a sec. I'll put this bit on. There we go. Such great fit with the panel fits on this model. But you see here, some of the glue just came away just now. I was putting this piece on, which sucks a bit. So I just push this together. You don't need to put that much pressure on, just be careful not to put my finger on bits. Seems to be pretty good. Just in that underside, no one's gonna see that piece. Make sure that's a good bind there. And just a bit of pressure. Just so that sits down all right. Ooh. Ah. See. Just gotta be so careful. This has come off my thumb there, or come onto my thumb. Okay, I'll let that dry for a bit, and then I'll put the wing sides on. One of the favourite things on a Phantom is the droop of these. Love that angle that they have, the view from the rear. I think that looks alright. I might just use the jig again, just to let that sit. I'll put on the second part. Really such a good fit, this model. All of these silver bits. Put it in the bin. All of these silver bits have just matched up really well. Now, also, I should have masked this direction so that the front edge is also silver, but I only found that out later when I was putting this together, so my fault. I also noticed that there needs to be a bit of an edge taken off right there, but if I do that, the underlying plastic colour may come through, so I might just leave it. The last things to paint is also the nozzles. Need to be a darker grey, not a silver like this. So that's probably going to be the last thing to paint up, and I'll do the inside and the outside, and then they'll go in there. And we can do a clear coat. I think we'll call it pretty much done on terms of the painting and the assembly. And the last bit will be the decals. Bit of a gap here, actually, just noticing. Okay. I think we can live with that as well. Decal time. I've got decals from NovaScale that I've used before, and they have these very thin water slides that are not cut out, so you've got to be very, very, very tight on them when you're cutting, and very, very careful when you put them down, because they're very thin and they tend to warp and rip and all sorts of stuff. But I've got the first couple on, the 20 number. They're looking okay at the moment, and might just put a little bit more mark fit on them just to make sure that they sit properly. And then we've got the roundels, the RAF roundels, to come on next as well. Oh, there's one already lifting. Okay, so better get that guy. There it is there, lifted off. Oh dear. Let's rescue the second one. Did say only 10 seconds. So we're gonna do this. Yeah, right. Okay. Too thick. Now, where's the picture? It is there. It's a little bit more inboard, yes. And there. Right, and try not to see what we can do with this one. So these are new tweezers that I've got actually as well. So that has come in handy straight away. Where does this sit in between the two lines? So we're going to encourage it forward a little bit. It's about as much messing around as I want to do. Oh. So yeah, the instructions were correct. 10 seconds is all you need in that water. Right, let's get these little pieces out. Looks okay from there. The other set of decals is from Fine Molds themselves, and there are just millions of them in there. Very, very finely done. It's going to be a challenge. I'm just going to grab the main ones. I'm not going to bother too much with the little things. I think I heard someone say once, don't go nuts and grab every single decal or stencil that you can. Just pick the ones that you want to highlight some things. So some of the red ones may be good, a couple of little black ones. Otherwise, that main red line is one of the important ones, as well as these interesting shapes here, which are always really challenging to get down and not get foggy. So I think this time I'm going to try putting a lot more mark fit down. What I might do actually is I might try this mark fit strong is what I normally use, but I also have micro set and micro sole, which I might try, and that may help with the fogginess. Just an experiment. So I might also do the shark's mouths, which I always think are awesome. I've got them on lots of my models. I think I'll go with the lights. That's probably about it. Let's see how we go. Okay, so some of the basic decals on now. Had quite some success using the micro sole. I think I'll keep using that actually. I think I quite like it compared to the Tamiya Mark Fit Strong. I've got the shark's tooth on the front there. Got the red stripe across the top and the kangaroo RAAF roundels, a couple of numbers on the tail there. Nothing too complicated on this one. I might put the red ejection warning things over just in front of the cockpit, but that's about it. I don't think I'm going to go too much more on this one in terms of the decals. There's heaps you could put on. Not really too interested in going over the top with that. Really interested to see though how you can see it in the reflection there, those parallelogram kind of things there, how whether or not they get very foggy as it dries. I've put quite a lot of microsole all over it, and maybe like three coats of the stuff, so just to see what happens and whether or not that fogginess is just because there's air that gets trapped underneath, or it's the glue not actually sitting down properly. I don't know what it is, but I'll find out in a day or two whether or not that lifts and starts getting bubbly and foggy like it normally does. They're very fiddly, thin decals, so it's I try not to kind of mess about too much with them, because you've done all this work to get to this point just to be let down by stuffing up some decals. So next step is probably those red ones there, and then a clear coat over the top, and then maybe a bit of weathering, and then I'm going to really try to figure out how to use this stand. I painted up this stand Because there's no wheels on this one. It is in flight and it's a clean one as well. No pylons or anything like that. So I just want to kind of get it at an angle. Just try to figure out how to do that. I might have to chop this down a bit to give it a bit of that lift look, and then maybe drill a whole bunch of holes and then glue it down on the underside. But all in all, pretty happy with how we're going. I think Fine Molds makes a really good model, so pretty happy most of the way. And then I've just got these exhausts to paint in a darker, it says steel, but it's just a darker metal colour than that, and they all fit in. I've just done a dry fit, so that fits in pretty well there. And then I'm pretty much done. So, and that's the one thing with having a jig, is it keeps falling off. So having wheels is obviously better because you can just plonk down the model. But yeah, looking good, I think. Oh, I did want to mention I bought a tweezer set, and this is one of the tweezers off. It's very fine, very small. It's perfect for playing with the decals. So I think this might be a winner, these very fine tweezers for very fiddly work. Yeah, really like it. So here's the Hobby Master display stand for 1 in 72 jets, F4, F16, F15. So I've got an F4 over there that I'm having trouble getting the air fix. It's having trouble getting this air fix thing to fit onto F4 Phantom bottom. So rather than kind of persisting with that, I'd remembered that I bought this thing. So, apologies for the scraping sound. So we've got a thin plastic base. So we've got some of these. Metal stand things. So that must sit in there with two little screws. And then you've got a combination of jets. So they look like they go together. That looks like an F-16 or something. These look kind of identical. Okay. F-15, F-16, F-4. Okay. Yeah. And here's my nozzles. Nozzle. It's the two. Oh yeah, that fits sweet. It's right up against that, look at that. So there's that one. That one's the same. That one's not the same. So that's really quite important to get the right one. Otherwise, there's no way. I thought I could have just winged it by just shoving any old crap in there, but that ain't gonna work. What's that for? F4, F15s maybe. Okay, cool. Well, these two are the ones we're gonna go with, which is awesome. So here we are with the final model sitting on the stand here. It's just a great stand actually. It's worked out really well. It sits really nicely, holds the jet perfectly. The only thing is you probably want to glue these stoppers in, because it is very easy if you're moving around the stand or you're moving the jet around and you're handling it. This is very smooth, so it will just fall straight out of the exhaust pipes like I just showed you. But otherwise, this was a great model by Fine Molds. 1 in 72 scale F4E, it's a Vietnam era one. Really, really well put together, really well engineered plastic, highly recommended. Any mistakes are your mistakes. The engineering is fantastic. Just some slight slivering silvering, sorry, on the decals there. That's to do with the smoothness of my paint. So I just need to work on that and work on a paint combination that's going to work in terms of giving me a really good finish and also allowing me to do some weathering. I've tried my hand at some weathering again at the back here, and you notice it's just another fail. Again, it's just learning about how the paints work. I tried some weathering here. It worked okay, but not what I was hoping for. Weapons next time, I think. There's really nice, you've got the grooves here for missiles and things like that. So I think the next model I will do a full loadout and go full beast mode. But as a clean jet, this is just a beautiful looking, the F4 is just a beautiful looking jet in its kind of clean form. Very enjoyable, highly recommended. Go get yourself one. I think they just came out last year, so this is like mid 2021 they came out with these from Fine Molds, and not cheap, but well worth the price because of the quality. So looking forward to trying out the Tamiya 1:48 scale, just to see how that goes and how that compares to this. I'll probably do exactly the same paint scheme and probably use the same paints, but try a different primer. So looking forward to building that guy. And otherwise, thanks for watching.